Our next system is the muscular system. And the muscular system is going to function both for voluntary movement. This is the movement you can decide to start and stop. And involuntary movement. And this is the automatic, unconsciously controlled kind of movement. This is things like your heartbeat, your lungs breathing, food moving through your digestive system, things that happen automatically. We can divide muscle into three main kinds: skeletal muscle, smooth muscle, and cardiac muscle. Skeletal muscle is going to work with tendons to attach to bones. It's going to be stimulated to action by the nervous system. It's going to get a stimulus from the nervous system that says it's time to contract. Movement actually occurs when muscles contract or shorten. So this is going to take ATP. Fibers are going to pull against each other in the muscle and pull against the bone, and that's going to create movement. Our muscles are arranged in what's called antagonistic pairs. And an antagonistic pair means that you have one muscle that contracts and moves a body part one way, and then an opposite one that moves the opposite way. So biceps and triceps and your upper arm are a great example. When you contract your bicep, your arm will move up, and when you contract your tricep on the back side of your upper arm, it will pull your hand back down. And this just allows fine-tuned control. What's really amazing to think about is the sets of pairs of muscles in something like your finger or your wrist, where you can rotate in circles and you're not just moving things up and down. So the muscular system is very complex and sort of elegantly designed to help us move around. Skeletal muscle is going to be involved primarily in voluntary movement. The muscles it takes to chew your food, to walk around, to write down answers, move your eyes, to read something on a screen, that's all going to be voluntary movement. Smooth muscle is used for movement inside the body. And to give you a couple examples, smooth muscle is what's going to help move your food through your digestive system. Smooth muscle is also what wraps around the uterus and does the wave-like contractions during birth. Generally, smooth muscle creates these very slow, sustained contractions. These are generally involuntary movement. So this isn't something you can think about. You can't decide, oh, I'm going to move some of my breakfast food down another inch in my small intestine right now. This just happens automatically, and we call that involuntary movement. Finally, cardiac muscle is very specialized muscle that you only find in the heart. It's activated by an electric current, and your heart has its own little pacemaker that sends out this electrical impulse, and it causes these muscles to contract in a rhythmic way for hopefully 85, 95 years of your life. Like the smooth muscle, the cardiac muscle is not under conscious control, and so it's controlled by a piece of our brain that we don't necessarily think about. It happens automatically. And here's a little review of the very basics of the muscular system.